Junior midfielder, number 2, Ben Holt. Senior forward, number 7, Zhao Hamyo. Senior forward, number 3, Charlie Matchell. Junior midfielder, number 10, Serge Gomez. Junior midfielder, number 12, Warren Austin. Freshman midfielder, number 13, Javier Alberto. Freshman defender, number 18, Joe Pickering. Junior defender, number 19, Chase Clack. Senior midfielder, number 21, Mitchell Casatello. Junior midfielder, number 24, Fletcher Aker. Sophomore goalkeeper, number 26, Johnny Sutherland. The head coach for ETSU is Bo Ashwani. And now the starting lineup for your Wofford Terriers. Freshman midfielder from Mount Pleasant, South Carolina, number 2, Sam Ross. Sophomore defender from Austin, Texas, number 6, Kyle Nelson. Junior defender from Norrköping, Sweden, number 7, Kevin Davidson. Junior forward from Lexington, South Carolina, number 8, Matthew Rednick. Freshman midfielder from Johnson City, Tennessee, number 11, Lucas Altman. Freshman midfielder from Simpsonville, South Carolina, number 14, Austin Tuggle. Freshman defender from Sarasota, Florida, number 16, Christian Wolmendorf. Sophomore midfielder from Greenville, South Carolina, number 19, Connor Donahue. Senior defender from Spartanburg, South Carolina, number 26, Tanner DeFreitas. Freshman defender from Windsor, Ontario, number 31, Drayton Kelly. Senior goalkeeper from Mount Pleasant, South Carolina, number 33, Joe Wickman. The Terriers are led by head coach Ralph Folsom, assistant coaches Shane Calvert, Thomas Humper, student assistant Darby Martins, and athletic trainer Riley Cox from the Sports Medicine Institute, a division of Spartanburg Regional Medical Health Services. Ladies and gentlemen, please rise, remove your hats. Veterans and military members out of uniform are encouraged to salute the flag as we honor America and the men and women around the world defending our freedom with the playing of our national anthem.
Thank you. Thanks so much for joining us on Terrier Vision. You're watching the Wofford men's soccer team host the Buccaneers of East Tennessee State University here in Spartanburg, South Carolina. We're at Snyder Field tonight on a beautiful Tuesday evening. The Terriers hoping to improve to 7-3 on the season. Meanwhile, ETSU looking to improve to 6-3-1. Both teams coming off a win. The Buccaneers coming off a win against Mercer, 2-1. And the Terriers had an impressive 6-1 victory on Saturday night as well. Right now, Mercer is the only common opponent that these two teams have faced. The Terriers fell to Mercer on the 27th last Tuesday, 2-0 in Macon. Opening kickoff just seconds away. Some early action for Joe Wickman, who's starting in goal tonight for the Terriers. He's been starting the last several games for the Terriers. The senior who has split time in his career along with fellow senior Garrett Kloss. That's Lucas Altman who has the ball at his feet for the Terriers. Inside the 18, takes a look on goal, and that one bounces off the right post. Connor Donahue is there looking for a follow-up. Touched by the Buccaneers. Kevin Davidson will take the throw in for Wofford tonight. The back line for the Terriers. Kevin Davidson is the outside right. Tanner DeFritis outside left. Kyle Nelson and Drayton Kelly as the two center backs. So these usual suspects on the Wofford back line. Starting in the midfield, Christian Wommeldorf, who's spent some time in the midfield this season along with the center back position. Connor Donahue is in the midfield, along with Austin Tuggle, who had a great game on Saturday against VMI. Up top for the Terriers, Lucas Altman, the target forward in the middle. The leading goal scorer, Matthew Rednick, over on the left side, and Sam Ross on the near outside right. ETSU is sitting second in the conference right now, just behind UNCG. Then Furman, followed by Wofford, Mercer, and VMI rounding out the conference standings. That's Johnny Sutherland taking the goal kick for the Bucks. And a ball played into the box. That one goes all the way across the frame of the goal before rolling out on the near sideline for a Wofford throw-in. Sam Ross with the flick. That one's going to go out of bounds over the near sideline. That's Sam Ross with the ball at his feet. Austin Tuggle trying to make a run in through that back line as Ross was looking to slip a ball through. Sutherland comes up with it in his hands. Freitas wins the header for the Terriers. Yep, Big ball sent forward. DeFreitas is there. He slid inside as Kelly slid to the outside left. Now Kelly's going to leave that one, slide back into the middle. DeFreitas will take the throw in for the Terriers. Great work from Tuggle in the midfield to win the ball. Drops it back to Wammeldorf and gets open, looking for Sam Ross on the near sideline. Good pressure up top from Sam Ross. Good step from Kyle Nelson. Another throw in for the Bucks. It's Wammeldorf with time and space in the midfield. He decides to take it. Ross making a great run in behind and a good ball played through by Tuggle. Great movement between Davidson, Tuggle, Ross. As Ross sends the ball towards the goal, that one's going to roll out over the end line, and Sutherland will take the goal kick for the Buccaneers. Left-footed look on goal. Wickman's going to collect that one for the Terriers. Donahue lets that one drop. Good ball played wide by Donahue. He finds DeFreitas, who sends a left-footed ball forward trying to find Altman. Good pressure by a redneck looking for Sam Ross in behind as he tries to look on goal. That one goes just wide right. And that'll be another goal kick for Sutherland as the Terriers have had several opportunities on goal here. Great win by Wammeldorf in the midfield. As Tuggle plays it out wide to a redneck. Ross is in the box. Tuggle making a run along with Donahue. Holt looking to make a clearance as Tuggle sends it back in, and a redneck's going to try it first time. That ball will bounce and ultimately end up in the hands of Sutherland. Holt plays it forward. Great tackle by Nelson. Romalo sends a ball into the box. That one goes right to Wickman as he'll collect it for the Terriers. Still 11. clearance out. Ends up with Austin Tuggle as he was trying to play it through to Rednick. Got stopped at Donahue. Kelly picks his head up, finds the feet of Tuggle, who's able to turn with it, plays it wide to Sam Ross. Ross trying to beat Holt and get a look in the box, cuts it back to his left. Good tackle from Holt. High pressure up top from the Bucks. Wommeldorf plays a first-time ball, looking for Altman in behind. Pickering comes in and picks it off for the Bucks. Good movement from Davidson, who found Ross and was looking to get up. Tuggle will find his feet. Ball played over the top. Kelly's able to get up, and a Wickman will come and collect it for the Terriers. Good win from Kelly on the back line. That's Romalo against Davidson on the back line. Right on the near side as Romalo will cut it into his right foot. Takes a look on goal. And Gomez was there to try it against Wickman as that ball went over the crossbar. Wickman will take the goal kick for the Terriers. Good flick from a Rednick and another one from Donahue as Ross will collect the ball with his feet, face up towards goal. He'll play it wide to a Rednick, who plays a first-time ball. Donahue is there for the Terriers. Cleared out by the Bucks. Now Davidson will send a direct ball, looking for Ross up top. That's Pickering, who plays it forward. Found the feet of Holt. Holt will cut it in. Ecker making a run as well, and Holt goes direct towards goal. Another one going over the crossbar as Wickman will end up with a goal kick for the Terriers. Rednick looks to settle the goal kick coming from Wickman. The Bucks are looking for Eckern in behind. DeFreitas drops it all the way back to Wickman, who picks his head up. He's going to go direct. Altman is up top. Sam Ross is able to collect it at his feet, cuts it back. finds Austin Tuggle in the midfield with time and space. Good ball movement as Donahue looks to get open inside the 18. He'll try a left-footed look on goal. Another great look for the Terriers as that one goes just wide right. And Sutherland will take the goal kick for the Buccaneers. Ball played wide. Kelly breaks it up for the Terriers as DeFritis will clear it forward. Altman is up there. Donahue getting up as well. Sutherland plays it forward. Eckern with a flick in behind. Foul called on the Bucks as Altman went down. And DeFritis is going to take the free kick for the Terriers. Rednick gets up. Donahue looks wide. Altman is there. He's slid over. Sends the ball towards the box. Altman tries to connect with the Donahue, who will settle it down. Now a ball sent inside the box. Ross is there just a bit over his head. Last touch by Ross. Ball still in bounds. Ross is able to keep it in play as Tuggle finds Davidson, who keeps it in bounds as well. Davidson looks to get a cross in. That one, last touch by the Bucks as Davidson will take the throw in now, looking for Altman up top. And a foul is called on Altman as he was able to hold off his defender. Referee heading over to talk to Altman, asking him not to talk back after the foul is called. And Sutherland will take the free kick for the Bucks inside of their own 18. Ball looks like it stayed in bounds as a big cross was sent into the box. Looking for Hamayo, who has the ball at his feet now, being defended by Ross, who came back all the way from up top. Kelly steps in to defend, tackles Hamayo. No foul called there as Hamayo is still down on top of the 18. Referee is going to allow the trainers to come on. Look at Mayo, who is still down on top of the 18 following that collision with Drayton Kelly. Clock is still running as of right now. And now the referee will indicate to stop the clock with 25 minutes remaining until halftime. And that was Maya who went off for the Buccaneers. Back in play now again. About 25 minutes remaining. The referee had stopped the clock right around 25 minutes. He actually pushed the clock back to about 26 minutes, allowing for that minute of time. But he let the clock run while the training staff was attending to Mayo. And that was Ecker, and he took a look on goal. That one went wide left. Did hear O'Shaughnessy asking for a corner kick, and that's what he got, as the Buccaneers will take their first corner kick on the night. Inside the box, DeFreitas got a touch on it. That was Gomez who sent it in the box. Altman is all the way back to help defend as Wickman goes down. Several attempts right inside the six in front of the post as Wickman was down, one of which sailed right across the face of the goal. Gomez with the ball at his feet being defended by four Terriers. Gomez goes down, no foul called. Ultimately cleared out as Ross and Rednick chase it up top. Last touch by the Terriers as the Buccaneers will take another corner kick here, this time from the opposite side of the field. Big ball sent in the box, and Nelson got up on it, along with Clack, as Davidson was fouled, and the Terriers will take a free kick. That one to be taken by Wickman from inside of his 18. Thank you. Nelson sends it forward, looking for Altman in behind. Sutherland's going to come outside the 18, bring that one back inside his box to pick it up with his hands. Pickering picks his head up, looking for Eckern up top. Nelson challenges for the header as Kelly sends it forward. Good pressure up top from Donahue as a big ball is sent forward. DeFreitas works to shield it out of bounds over the end line. And Wickman will take the goal kick for the Terriers. Waldorf in the midfield. Referee recognizes that there was a foul called. He calls advantage instead as Altman and Ross both go down. Last touch by the Buccaneers, and Davidson will take the throw-in for the Terriers. Davidson sends the ball inside the box. Rednick is there. He's able to get up and get a touch on it as that ball goes out over the far sideline, and the Buccaneers will take a throw in from deep within their own half. Pickering has the ball at his feet. Holt is wide. He'll choose to find Holt here on the near sideline. That's Woodfin who finds Eckern. Woodfin making a run across the top. And Rednick comes back all the way from the top line to help defend on top of his own 18. Holt sends the ball towards the top of the 18. DeFreitas gets a touch on it, turns wide, plays a left-footed ball forward. That one's going to go out over the far sideline, and the Buccaneers will take a throw-in. High pressure up top from a Rednick. That ball rolls out of bounds. A flick from Tuggle. Several passes looking for Altman up top. Kelly sends it forward first time. Donahue looks to settle it down. A Rednick will find Donahue again on the outside, and the Terriers are looking forward. Sam Ross inside the box, and the AR on the near side is going to raise his flag before Sam Ross is able to get a look on goal. And Sutherland will take the free kick for the Buccaneers following that offsides call. But a good buildup from the Terriers between a Rednick and Donahue as Donahue's on a left-footed ball looking for Ross as that target forward as he had slid over. Great turn from Ross, and then Lucas Altman makes a great run out wide to replace him. Ross goes down and the referee will call a foul. Looks like Donahue is going to get behind it. Waldorf will drop back from the midfield to cover on defense as the Terriers send two of their strongest headers forward in their center backs, Nelson and Kelly. Nelson gets a look on it. Great win from Kelly off that back line. And that's Eckern, who takes another look on goal. The Bucks have had several shots from pretty far out that have gone over the crossbar. Joe Wickman will take the goal kick for the Terriers. Good flick from Rednick. You can hear head coach Ralph Polson for the Terriers saying second, talking about the second ball if Rednick's going to win the first one. Polson's looking for another Terrier to win that second ball. The defense up top from Woodfin and Donahue trying to slip one in behind, looking for Sam Ross. Woodfin now has the ball at his feet. And good pressure from Ross. Last touch by Ross. High pressure in the midfield from Donahue. And good work from Ross as Donahue is now open. Takes a touch diagonally towards the goal as he'll look for a left-footed look on goal. A Redneck is asking for it in behind on the ground. And that one goes out over the end line, and Sutherland will take the goal kick for the Buccaneers. Referee calls a foul. A little bit in front of midfield. Nelson gets up and gets ahead on it. Tuggle sends it wide towards Donahue as the referee gets in the way. Terriers still end up with it as Ross looking for Rednick, who gets on his horse looking to get a touch around Sutherland. And Sutherland was outside of his box when he came to pick that ball up. Touched the ball with his hands outside of his 18. Referee is indicating to stop the clock as he works this out. Referee indicating that the Terriers will have a free kick just outside of the 18. As the referee will work to organize the wall 10 yards back. The Buccaneers going with five in the wall. Donahue and Davidson are both over the ball as the referee just issued Sutherland a yellow card for using his hands outside of the 18. The defending Southern Conference Player of the Year, of the week, I should say. Donahue tries a left-footed look towards goal. That one bounces off the wall. Donahue's going to take a quick throw looking for Altman up top, who is in behind. High pressure from Donahue and a good tackle on the back line. Just under 15 minutes remaining in the first half. Good win from Sam Ross. As the Buccaneers are looking for Woodfin up top as Eckern goes down without a touch. Tuckle looking for a direct head. Davidson's going to let that one roll out of bounds as he'll take the throw in for the Terriers. Holtman chests it down, turns with it, and looks for Sam Ross forward. Great pressure from Davidson as Tuggle has the ball. He faces up looking for Ross, who is trying to stay on sides. Last touch by the Buccaneers.
Substitutions for Wofford. In number 18, Nikki Watson. And number 21, Andreas Suri.
Sam Ross and Connor Donahue check out of the game. In comes Andre Suri along with Nikki Watson. Nikki Watson had a great game against VMI on Saturday, opened up the scoring for the Terriers on the day in their 6-1 victory over the Keydets. Davidson takes the throw looking for a Rednick in the box who's able to get a flick on it. Clearance forward, intercepted by Nelson. Wommeldorf now looks for a Rednick inside the box. A choice from DeFreitas as he settles it down with his chest. Woodfin was there to break it up. Great pressure from DeFreitas. As Wommeldorf will play it back to Nelson on the back line. Nelson picks his head up, finds a Rednick who looks to get a flick in behind as Tanner DeFreitas is making a run up top all the way from the back line. Holt sends the ball into the box looking for Eckern. Nelson breaks it up. Davidson looking for an offsides call. And the referee's going to call a foul. Looks like he's going to call offsides. AR on the far side raised his flag. And Wickman is going to take the free kick for the Terriers. Davidson was looking for Suri on a through ball. Gomez with the ball at his feet. A Rednick comes back to help defend. Ecker drops it back. The Bucks looking for Holt out wide, and Davidson is going to shield that one out over the end line. And Wickman will take the goal kick for the Terriers.
In for Wofford, number 28, Jack Sicker.
Jack Sicker comes in to replace Matthew Rednick up top as the left forward. Lucas Altman is still in there as the target forward with Nikki Watson out right. Go, 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 go! drops it back to Pickering, being defended by Altman. Ball switched around the back line. Now a big ball sent forward, and Joe Wickman will collect that one in his hands. Great work from Kelly as he cuts it back, looks for Nelson. Nelson sends a first time ball to Davidson, right around his defender. A good choice from Davidson to find the feet of Altman. Altman drops it back. Davidson finds Altman again, who sends a ball inside the box. And it looks like Jack Sicker was making a run, trying to get a touch on it inside the 18. And Sutherland is able to collect it for the Buccaneers. Remember, the Buccaneers have held their opponents scoreless in the last seven matches, almost 650 minutes as of right now of scoreless play. A very strong defense from the Buccaneers. Kelly sends the ball forward. Siri gets up, gets ahead on it for the Terriers. Ball still in bounds. Woodfin has it at his feet. Siri was able to get a touch on it. That ball now with Gomez as Watson works to get back. Davidson will slide over and defend Holt. And now Holt is inside the 18, takes a look on goal, and Kelly was right there before Wickman even had to make a save. And Kelly with another great win. Referee calls advantage there, indicates that there was a foul by Eckern on Kelly. And that ball will roll out of bounds for a Buccaneers throw-in.
Substitution for ETSU, number 27, Luke Parker.
That's it. Gomez with the ball at his feet. Tuggle slides over to help defend. Woodfin in there as well as Gomez drops it back. Holt takes a great first touch as Watson slides over to defend, and the referee will call a foul on Watson. Looks like Davidson may have said something to the referee after the foul was called. Wickman only putting two in the wall from this free kick just outside the 18. That's a Woodfin who sent a ball inside the box, bouncing around. And the ball is played forward. DeFreitas is there, and Wommeldorf steps. Last touch by the Terriers, as you can hear Wickman telling his team to step up, trying to catch some of the Buccaneers offsides. Instead, that ball rolls out for another corner kick for ETSU. Head that goes right across the frame of the goal. The Buccaneers have had several opportunities to go right across that 6-yard box for the Terriers. Under 5 minutes remaining until halftime. Still no score here at Snyder Field. Good ball movement from the Buccaneers as Gomez falls over. No foul called. Altman has the ball at his feet, cuts it back to his left, looking for Jack Sicker on the far side. Couple slides. Terriers trying to hold on to possession. And DeFreitas working to keep that one in bounds. And the Buccaneers will take a throw in from deep within their own half. Ball still in bounds. Andre Siri able to turn with it. Still in bounds as he dribbles, looking for a cross to be sent in the box. Last touch by the Buccaneers. Siri will take a quick throw in. Sicker drops it back. Altman tries a first time look on goal. That one goes over the crossbar, and Sutherland will take the goal kick for the Buccaneers. Big kick forward, Wommeldorf getting up to challenge. That's Gomez with the ball at his feet. Plays it wide to Parker, who will drop it back. Ball played wide as Sicker slides over to help defend.
1 minute remaining in the first half. 1 minute.
Alberto finds Woodfin, who turns with it. Ball sent through. Wickman will slide over. Great choice. Instead of trying to drag the ball inside the box to pick it up, he'll find DeFreitas, who plays it forward. That one goes out of bounds over the far side. Good step from Siri in the midfield. Last touch by the Buccaneers, less than 15 seconds remaining as Davidson will take the throw.
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0.
And that's how the first half will end. Still scoreless here at Snyder Field. The Terriers with 8 shots on goal and the Buccaneers with 6. We'll be back in just a couple minutes with your second half action.
While we set up the field.
Set! Red 97!
Did you say 97?
Yes.
You know, that reminds me of Geico's 97% customer satisfaction rating.
97%?
Helped by Geico's fast and friendly claim service.
Oh yeah, baby. Geico's as fast and friendly as it gets.
Geico. Expect great savings and a whole lot more.
Hard playing kids, taking the ball all the way in. College athletes burning up the tracks. It doesn't matter if you're an elite athlete, a weekend warrior, or just into casual recreation. If you get hurt, the doctors, athletic trainers, and physical therapists at Spartanburg Regional Sports Medicine Institute will get you back into your game better than ever. We utilize the latest in orthopedic care so you can return from injury to the energetic lifestyle you love. To find out more, call us at 864-606-4931.
Seven conference championships, titles are forever.
We are the Southern Conference.
And it's on us to stop sexual assault on our college campuses. To get in the way before it happens.
To get a teammate or friend home safe.
To not blame the victim.
We are the Southern Conference.
And it's on us to look out for each other on our campuses.
To not turn a blind eye.
To intervene when something isn't right.
We are the Southern Conference.
And it's on us to stand up.
To step in. To take responsibility.
We are the Southern Conference, and we take the pledge to stop sexual assault.
It's on us, all of us, to make a difference on our campuses.
Join us and take the pledge to be a part of the solution at itsonus.org.
I'm John I. Marino, Commissioner of the Southern Conference, and I'm thrilled to be able to announce that ESPN and the Southern Conference have signed an agreement to have our member institutions produce live sporting events for ESPN3, with all 10 members being on board by the 2017-18 academic year. Mercer actually had started doing ESPN3 the year before they joined the conference. It was an initiative by their previous conference, and so we were able to use a lot of their expertise. They were very helpful in getting us started, in having their video people talk with some of our video people. So we use that kind of as the foundation and have built from there. And I think what we've learned is we've come a long way in a very short period of time. Our video coordinators have done a great job, and our administrators, including the presidents and chancellors, have been very supportive of this. We've come a long way in a short period of time. We've learned from each other. We've done a lot of had a lot of conversations about best practices and things to look for and things to anticipate. It's a situation where everybody's had to learn new equipment. You know, fortunately, we were able to take some operating reserves and purchase equipment for everybody. That's made the transition easier. By the end of this year, the end of this basketball season, I believe 9 of our 10 schools will have at least produced at least one men's basketball game for ESPN3, and most of them, 5 or 6 of them at least. Not only are we using staff employees, we're also using students, and we're getting some tremendous experience for our students who want to learn how to operate a camera, how to produce an event, how to do graphics for a televised event. They're great learning experiences. The creation of the SoCon Digital Network last year and then the move to ESPN3 within a couple of years, I think it works, you know, hand in glove. We were hoping to maybe do 250 events last year. In the first year of the SoCon Digital Network, we wound up doing 608. We're already over 900 or so total since we launched a year ago in August. But the SoCon Digital Network is not being phased out by ESPN3. I think we're going to get to a point where most of the football and basketball will be housed on ESPN3, and selected games from sports like soccer and volleyball and softball, baseball and lacrosse. But there's always going to be a place for the SoCon Digital Network. Our schools just don't have the resources to move everything over to ESPN3. There are going to be times where there are conflicts, where there are two events going on at once. Maybe more resources are devoted to the ESPN3 broadcast in that situation. But I'm confident that the SoCon Digital Network will remain a place where people will go to watch SoCon content.
Titles are forever. Championships. Titles are forever.
Madness begins here. Make sure you're at the U.S. Cellular Center in Asheville, North Carolina, March 2nd through 6th for the 2017 SoCon Basketball Championships presented by General Shale. You don't want to miss the action as your favorite SoCon teams compete for a championship and a berth in the NCAA tournament. Book your travel and tickets by logging on to SoConTravel.com or by contacting the U.S. Cellular Center box office. Madness begins here. Get your tickets today.
Hi, I'm John Imerino, Commissioner of the Southern Conference. With the full cooperation of our presidents and chancellors, the conference has created the SoCon Academic Exchange, a cooperative structure designed to benefit our academic efforts. Three primary initiatives will be the collaboration of international study programs, a leadership development program to benefit faculty and staff, and an undergraduate research forum. For more information on the SoCon Academic Exchange, visit SoConSports.com.
Located in Spartanburg, South Carolina, Wofford College combines a challenging liberal arts education with a close-knit campus community. Wofford offers a complete, transformative living and learning experience. Wofford empowers its students with skills and opportunities that employers need and graduate schools want. A Wofford graduate is prepared for what's next. Wofford College. It's your world.
These are the student athletes. This is where they train. These are their homes. This is where they become Rhodes Scholars and academic All-Americans. These are the athletes they've always admired. This is where champions are crowned and moments are made. This is the Southern Conference.
Wofford College combines a challenging liberal arts education with a close-knit campus community. Located in Spartanburg, South Carolina, Wofford offers 25 major fields of study and a faculty that mentors students to think independently, develop goals, and work creatively. At Wofford, 93% of students choose to live on campus all 4 years. It's an enriching residential experience that culminates at The Village. The NCAA Division I Wofford Terriers compete in the Southern Conference across 18 teams. As the Terriers continue to excel with community support, they're always the best game in town. A few miles away is Wofford's Goodall Environmental Study Center. Overlooking Lawson's Fork of the Pacolet River, the center features exceptional opportunities for hands-on environmental experience. While Wofford's campus can take your breath away, nestled in the foothills of the Blue Ridge Mountains and just a few hours from the beach, Wofford ranks consistently as a top 10 college for study abroad experience. Students are prepared for the world after Wofford. At The Space, students learn skills and find experiences that employers need and graduate schools want. Our graduates are prepared for what's next. Wofford College, it's your world.
Welcome back into Terrier Vision. You're watching the second half of the Wofford men's soccer team host the Buccaneers at BTSU. Score tied 0-0 after 45 minutes of play. The Terriers had 8 shots on goal in the first half. The Buccaneers with 6. Johnny Sutherland for the Buccaneers had 2 saves in the first half. Joe Wickman for the Terriers with 1. The Terriers out with the same lineup that started the first half. Joe Wickman in goal. Nelson and Kelly as the center backs, with DeFritis and Davidson on either side. Wommeldorf, Donahue, and Tuggle in the midfield, with Altman, Rednick, and Ross up top. That's Wommeldorf, who got up in the midfield to win the ball. Foul called on Eckern, and the Terriers will have a free kick in front of midfield to be taken by Donahue. Kelly inside the box was able to wind up and take a look on goal, and that one's going to go out over the end line, and Sutherland will take the goal kick for the Buccaneers. First time ball won by Rednick. Goes out over the near sideline. Buccaneers will take the throw. A reminder that we did have an injury substitution in the first half for the Buccaneers. Hamayo went out, and he has yet to return following a collision with Drayton Kelly just on top of the Terriers 18 in the first half. Eckern with the ball at his feet, looking for Secatello, and another ball that's played across the frame of the goal. The Terriers got lucky on that one as Wickman was out of his goal as he stepped to the ball instead. That one last touch by the Terriers, and the Buccaneers will have another corner kick on the night. Left-footed in-swinger, DeFritis was able to get ahead on it first time. Altman trying to check back. Nelson wins the header. Davidson looked to clear it forward, and Wickman's going to come off his line to collect it for the Terriers. A quick punt. A Rednick is going to drop back. He gets a touch on it. Ball goes out of bounds on the near sideline. Good work from a Rednick to drop it back. DeFritis finds the feet of Tuggle, who finds a Rednick, takes a big touch forward into traffic. And the Buccaneers will clear it out as Wofford's leading goal scorer is on the ground, Matthew Rednick. Thank you. And that's Matthew Redneck being helped off right now by the Wofford training staff. Favoring his left ankle. Checking in his place is Jack Sicker, who just jogged onto the field. Remember, the Buccaneers cleared that one out voluntarily as Redneck was down. Freitas is going to find Sam Ross, who will drop it all the way back to Sutherland as a courtesy for kicking it out when Redneck was down. And Kelly gets up and is able to win that ball. That is a left-footed ball is sent in the box by Eckern. And Wickman collects it for the Terriers. That's Austin Tuggle with the ball at his feet, finds Altman. Sicker looking to make a run while staying on sides. He's able to stay on sides. Sends a cross inside the box, broken up and ultimately cleared out by the Buccaneers. DeFreitas steps in and then Kelly. And Kelly will dish it off to Donahue. Donahue, the captain, dribbling forward. Playing Sam Ross, who's able to take a touch inside, send a ball inside the box, and a great run from Tuggle in the AR. Will raise his flag to indicate offsides called on Terriers. That one called on Ross, not on Tuggle, so offsides before Ross is even able to send a ball inside the box. Will take the free kick. And a nutmeg from Secatello through DeFreitas as Wommeldorf clears it out. The ball sent back inside the box. Davidson looking to clear it out as the AR on the near side raises his flag. Buccaneers are offsides. And Wickman will take the free kick for the Terriers. Altman, high pressure up top. Ross is able to intercept it. Big ball played forward, looking for Eckern. Kelly gets up. Ball drops towards DeFreitas, and he'll play it back to Wickman. High pressure up top from Altman. Sam Ross was looking to take a quick throw. Referee said last touch was by Wofford, indicating an ETSU throw-in. Wommeldorf settles it down. Good job. Bucks are looking for a second. Tello on a through ball, using his speed to get in behind DeFreitas. Broken up by Kelly and Nelson on the back line. And good talk from Wickman as he tells DeFreitas to leave the ball. He comes way off his line to clear that ball out of bounds over the near sideline. Ball played to Eckern. Dropped back with the heel. And DeFreitas gets up to win the header. That ball goes out over the end line. And the Buccaneers will have another corner kick on the night. Gomez goes to take the corner. Good header from DeFreitas. As Kelly clears it out, and that one goes out over the near sideline before Altman is able to get a touch. And a look on goal by Mayo. That one goes just wide left, and Joe Wickman will take the goal kick for the Terriers. DeFreitas clears it forward. Sam Ross is there looking to settle it down. Great job, finds a through ball to Ross, who plays a left-footed ball, and Altman is able to get ahead on it. The Johnson City, Tennessee native able to find the back of the net, and the Terriers take the 1-0 lead after a great play between Donahue and the first-time ball from Ross inside the box.
Walker goal scored by number 11, Lucas Altman. Assist by number 19, Connor Donahue, and number 2, Ross.
That is Altman's first career goal. Again, the freshman from Johnson City, Tennessee, the defending Tennessee Gatorade State Player of the Year. Played forward from Wammeldorf in the midfield. Altman gets a touch on it. Now Donahue will collect it. Jack Sicker is wide left. Donahue lays it out for Sicker. Sends a left-footed ball inside the six, and Sutherland collects it for the Buccaneers.
Same way.
Wickman sends it forward. Altman looking to get a flick in behind to Sicker. Now Wommeldorf looking for Tuggle on a through ball. Ball sent inside the box. That one goes all the way across the frame of the goal. Hamayo has the ball at his feet. Drops it inside the 18. Bounce off the post. Sacatello goes in for Tuggle with a tackle. A great work. Great job from Tuggle to drop back there. That ball is going to go out over the end line. And Wickman will take a goal kick as the Terriers get lucky again as the Buccaneers get another great look on goal. Sicker, who has the ball to speed. Altman making a run across the top, and Sicker will replace him inside. Nelson makes a great touch on it, sends it forward first time. Run out wide. Ross will drop back, cuts off the pass to Austin as Wommeldorf picks his head up, finds Tuggle in the midfield. George faces up towards goal. Woodfin making a run out wide. Eckern showing feet. And then Spielman sends a ball inside the box. Eckern gets ahead on it inside the six. Nelson was there as well. That one goes out over the end line. And Joe Wickman will take another goal kick on the night as the Buccaneers even the shots at 10. Ball goes out of bounds after Sam Ross worked to keep it in. Austin with the ball at his feet drops it back. Clack sends it all the way forward as Davidson wins the header. Good chest pass from Gomi. Last touch by the Buccaneers is what the center ref originally said. Now he's saying last touch by Wofford as the Buccaneers will get a substitution.
And for ETSU, number 16, Euro.
The Terriers looking to get a substitution as well while the play is stopped.
In for Wofford, number 21, Andreas Siri.
Andreas Siri checks back in, replaces Austin Tuggle in the midfield. Foul called on Jack Sicker. George plays Eckern up top, being defended by Kelly. And that first time ball goes out over the near sideline, and DeFreitas will take the throw in for the Terriers. Altman drops back. Ross has it at his feet. And the referee will call a handball. Goes out over the crossbar, and that results in another corner kick for the Terriers. As DeFritas goes down. Foul called on Gomez. Looks like Donahue is behind the ball for the Terriers, taking a left-footed free kick forward again, trying to find Nelson or Kelly inside the box. Nelson went for an ambitious bicycle kick. We also had a bike attempt in the VMI game on Saturday. Matthew Arednick attempted one inside the box. That's Hamayo on the counterattack. Eckern is there as well. A shot on goal. Wickman able to get a hand on it as that ball will roll out of bounds for now an ETSU corner kick just seconds after the Terriers got theirs off on the other end of the field. Ball sent inside the box, and Nelson gets ahead on it as the Terrier back line steps up as Joe Wickman instructs them to. And an attempt on goal with the head. A ball ends up in the hands of Joe Wickman as he'll punt it forward. Wickman will take his time to pick that ball up as Eckern steps to pressure, taking a few more seconds off the clock. Wommeldorf finds the feet of Donahue, plays it wide to Sicker. Altman and Ross are in the box as Sicker looks to get a cross in. Donahue using some trickery get through two men as he cuts in towards the 18. Cuts it back to his left, trying to find Altman, who is 45 degrees back towards the top of the 18. Ball rolls out of bounds for a Terrier throw-in.
In for Walker, number 18, Nikki Bonson.
Ball played forward. A foul is called up top on the Buccaneers, and the Terriers will have a free kick that they will treat much like a corner kick, just a little bit closer in towards the 18. Again, Donahue will take his time to walk over to the spot of the foul, take some time off of the clock. Left left-footed ball sent in. Nelson was there. Siri got a touch on it inside the 18. Watson gets up for the header. That's Donahue, who is looking to settle it down, and now Gomez will play it forward. That's Hamayo. Tanner DeFritis drops it back to Wickman, who instructs him to drop it back. He finds Ross on the near sideline. Kelly plays the ball forward. A great turn from Donahue. He's had some great work on the ball tonight, cutting it back towards his right. Wicker has the ball at his feet. Dribbling, cuts it back to his right. And great work from Sicker, who's able to get a corner kick out of that, although he wasn't able to get a cross off. The next best thing, as Mickey Watson will jog out to the corner flag to take the corner kick for Wofford. Instead, the Terriers will waste a little bit more time, and they'll send Watson back into the 18 and allow Kevin Davidson to jog over to take the kick. Kelly was able to get ahead on it. No one there on that near post from the corner kick. Touch by the Buccaneers as Davidson will take his time to get the throw in off for the Terriers. Wommeldorf gets a touch on it, and then Nelson goes up for the header. A foul is called again on Eckern. Take the free kick for the Terriers. A big ball sent forward. Watson is out there on the outside right. Sicker goes down, and another foul is called on the Buccaneers. Another free kick to be taken from outside of the 18. And Donahue both over this ball as Donahue chooses to take a left-footed look towards goal, looking for Kelly on the back post. That one goes out over the end line, and Sutherland will take the goal kick for the Buccaneers. Woodfin checks back in for the Buccaneers. Who is down again for the Buccaneers. Again, he went off in the first half following a collision with Drayton Kelly. Thank you. again, that's Tamaya, who is walking off without help. Ball is back with Sutherland, remember? A goal kick for the Buccaneers. Clock starts again. Under 20 minutes remaining. And Sicker chases up top. Watson drops it back to Davidson. And Davidson looking for a through ball, trying to find Sicker. Referee called a foul outside of the 18. Breaks up a bit of talk between two players up top. Siri gets up to win it, and then Kelly DeFreitas with a first time left footed clearance out of the back. Gomez looking for a look down the line as Kelly clears it out, then clears it out even further. Sissoko taking the throw for the Buccaneers. That's Nicky Watson, who's able to get a touch on it. Sicker comes back. Referee calls a handball on Sicker, and the Buccaneers will have a free kick. Wickman calling for it, but instead Wommeldorf was able to get ahead on it. Wickman retreated back into his goal, and Wommeldorf cleared it all the way out. It out. Now it's Siri with the ball at his feet, looks forward. Sicker is up top along with Ross and Nicky Watson working to break up the pass. And that's Woodfin, the leading goal scorer for the Buccaneers. Ball at his feet. Kelly with a great slide tackle denies the cross. And Woodfin is going to jog over the corner to take a seventh corner kick on the night for the Buccaneers. Headed out by Suri, that's Woodfin with the ball at his feet. DeFreitas slides out to pressure. Wickman instructing his back line, everybody to step outside of the 18. A foul is called on Sicker. And the referee is going to stop the clock. As the Buccaneers set up the free kick, looks like the referee has issued Andres Suri a yellow card as he'll step back into the wall 10 yards back. And the AR on the near side has raised his flag before any attempt is taken on goal by the Bucs. Davidson plays the ball forward. Sicker gets a touch on it. Watson now has the ball at his feet, looking in towards goal. Suri is inside along with Ross. Last touch by the Buccaneers. And it's the Terriers will take the throw-in.
Number 11, Lucas Altman.
Charlie Heffron checks in, and Altman checks back into the match. This time, Altman checking into the midfield while Heffron goes up top, along with Watson and Ross. Great work from Connor Donahue, who has the ball at his feet. Donahue plays it forward. Watson in traffic. Last touch by the Buccaneers as the Terriers will take the throw in. Kevin Davidson will jog forward. 13 minutes remaining in the match. Last touch by the Buccaneers. Another throw in to be taken by Davidson. Ball headed out. Altman trying to keep it inside of the Terrier half. The foul is called on Wommeldorf, and the referee is going to stop the clock. Wommeldorf come over before the free kick is taken. The referee is going to issue a Wommeldorf yellow card now. Another yellow card on the match.
In for Wofford, number 14, Austin Tuggle.
Ralph Poulsen will sub out Wommeldorf, who just received that yellow card. Put in Tuggle. Gomez got up and got a head on it. Davidson will clear it way out over the far side. Assistant coach Thomas Hunter got up off the bench really quickly, used his old goalkeeping skills from his days here at Wofford, threw it forward quickly so that the Buccaneers could get a quick throw-in off. Now under 12 minutes remaining. Gomez sends a ball inside the box. Kelly gets ahead on it as he's running backwards. Ross steps to defend along with Kelly. Sissoko is looking for an attempt on goal. Now it's Heffron up top in high pursuit. Sutherland outside the 18. And that ball is still in bounds as Woodfin and DeFreitas will work for it. Great work from DeFreitas. Drops it back to Kelly, who sends a first-time ball forward. Heffron looking for Watson on the other side. And that ball, last touch by the Buccaneers, and DeFreitas will walk over to take the throw-in for the Terriers. George, with the ball at his feet, finds Gomez, turns Altman. Gets past Kelly, and then Nelson comes over to cover, and great job by Nelson as he defends Woodfin, and that ball goes out of bounds for a Buccaneers throw-in to be taken quickly. Sissoko with the ball at his feet, looking for Woodfin. ball sent inside the box. Kelly is there, able to get ahead on it as he falls over. DeFrieda's trying to keep that one in bounds, and he's able to do so to prevent corner kick. Now under 10 minutes remaining. Tuggle leading Heffron up top. Heffron, high pressure up top. Donahue able to keep the ball as Ross was there as an option as well. Donahue working to get through traffic. Great win from Sam Ross. Tuggle plays it forward to Heffron. Donahue trying to find Heffron through. And there is a foul called back where Connor Donahue was looking for that ball through. Referee is going to not stop the clock. Thought he was issuing for the clock to stop there. Actually just issuing for Wickman to send a ball forward. Donahue and Watson over the ball. Watson takes a left-footed ball forward as two men go down in the box. Nelson being one of them. Three goals on the year off of free kicks that found his head, that found the back of the net. He goes down, no foul called as Sutherland takes a quick goal kick for the Buccaneers. Altman with a great win in midfield. Sissoko finds Gomez looking to switch the field. Instead, that one's picked off by Watson, who finds Donahue. He plays Davidson out wide. A great run from Heffron across the top line, switches places with Watson. That ball cleared out of bounds. And Davidson will walk over to take the throw for the Terriers. Flick from Watson. That ball goes out of bounds over the far side. Watson, Altman finds Tuggle inside. Ross is getting wide. And Davidson let that ball roll out of bounds as the Terriers take a substitution.
For Wofford, number 15, Nash Wagner.
Wagner checks in to replace Sam Ross up top. A great game from Ross on that top line for the Terriers as Davidson takes a throw. Great win from Kelly over Eckern. Donahue finds the feet of Heffron. Tackle from Tuggle. George finds Gomez in the midfield. Looking for Woodfin on the through ball. Watson cuts it back to his left foot, looking for Heffron up top. Altman will settle it down as he is fouled right around midfield as Altman goes down. Foul called on Marchell. Watson with the touches. That ball goes out of bounds.
In for Javier Almeida.
Five minutes remaining as Kelly gets a big clearance on it. That one stays in bounds. Tuggle gets a touch on it. Trying to send Heffron in behind. Sizoko sends a ball towards the goal. That one a bit too much as it goes out over the end line. And Wickman will take the goal kick for the Terriers. By the time he gets this off, there will be 4 minutes remaining. Ball bounces out of bounds before Wagnon is able to get a touch on it. George plays the ball forward, finds Eckering. Drops it back to Alberto. Ball played forward, Davidson breaks it up. And Nelson goes to ground, no foul called, although George went down. Donahue will play left-footed ball over to Nikki Watson, just a bit too much. And the Buccaneers will take a throw-in. Great win from Nelson on the back line over Ecker. Nelson wanted a foul called there. And Wickman will call Nelson off that one, allow the ball to roll all the way back before picking it up. Now under 3 minutes remaining. Big kick forward from Wickman. Heffron gets a flick on it. Wagnon pressuring up top. DeFreitas able to win the header over Woodfin. Sizoko plays it forward, finds the feet of Alberto, looking for Eckern on the through ball, broken up by Kelly, who's a little bit slow to get up as he jogs back. Big ball sent forward, looking for Eckern again. Lucas Altman, high pressure on Woodfin. Able to turn, look inside the box, and a look on goal as Wickman makes a great save. And the AR on the near sideline raised his flag. No foul is called. And it looks like Alberto went down. Left-footed ball sent in the box. Wickman comes off his line. And a great series from the Buccaneers as they get several looks on goal. Wickman coming up with several big saves. And pressure up top from Heffron. Now Wagnon going for it, and that ball will roll out of bounds. Or a Terrier throw-in as we approach the 1 minute mark.
1 minute, 1 minute.
Heffron goes to the ground, no foul is called. Woodfin settles it down, drops it back. Big ball played forward. Davidson is able to get a touch on it. Now Tuggle looking for Donahue in the midfield. Nelson comes in to make a tackle. Nothing called, although Eckern went down. 20 seconds remaining as Davidson slides out to pressure. Ball sent inside the box. Woodfin looks for a flick. Nelson is there, and Heffron will send a big ball forward as he's tripped
up. eight,
Sutherland
seven,
sending one
six,
last attempt on
five, four,
goal as
three, two, one, zero.
The Terriers come away with a 1-0 victory over the Buccaneers of ETSU following a 56-minute goal from Lucas Altman. Thanks so much for joining us on Terrier Vision. We'll see you back here next week as the Terriers host the Spartans of UNC Greensboro.
The final score of the night's match.